Hello guys, and welcome back to I Never Knew That. So today, we are going to be talking about Leonardo da Vinci. So Leonardo da Vinci had many different talents. He was an artist, an architect, a military engineer, and a theatrical producer. He had an amazing talent in painting, but his interests were so diversified that he actually did not paint as many paintings as many other famous painters did. And we can only for sure attribute about 36 paintings to da Vinci, whereas Raphael, another very famous painter, painted 47. One neat thing about da Vinci's paintings is that he used very interesting visual effects that are fairly non-existent in others, and they give his paintings a very neat visual aspect to them when you look at them. As a person, da Vinci wore very flamboyant clothes. He was ambidextrous, so he could use both his right and his left hand, and some accounts say that he would paint with one hand and write with the other, or draw with the other. He was a vegetarian, and he has been called as somewhat eccentric. His greatest competitor was Michelangelo, a very famous painter at the time also, but there's a little contention between them. So a competition was organized where they would both paint their own painting, and then they would be judged to see who was the better painter. Well, they both actually ended up kind of going into a little feud between them, and they never actually finished the paintings for that competition. So there is no clear winner between who's the better painter, Da Vinci or Michelangelo. One thing that gives many researchers a problem when they're attempting to attribute a painting to Da Vinci is that he actually did not sign his paintings. So it's kind of more guessing if it has his style and if it was mentioned by him in his writings or if someone else, like a historian at the time, attributed the painting to him. So that may be one reason why we only have 36 paintings attributed to him. He may have painted more, but it's impossible for us to know for sure. He was also very interested in mechanics and mechanical devices. And as a theatrical producer, he often wanted amazing devices to bring actors down on the stage. So he would build these amazing machines, and he would hang them from ropes and lower down his actors, and they would just add to the effect of the play. Well, later on, he realized that some flying machines actually might have a physical potential. So then he would draw out all these neat machines in his drawings, and later on, some of them would actually become invented, and they actually worked fairly well with some slight modifications. At one time, there was a little contention between him and the Pope of Florence, Italy, where he lived. So what he did was he started becoming very knowledgeable about the human body in hopes that making new discoveries about the body would bring him back into the good favor of the Pope. We're not really sure if this happened or not, but Da Vinci did become very knowledgeable about the human body and about the eye and the vocal cords and all the muscles and the ligaments in the body. And in one of his most famous paintings, and what has often been called the most famous painting in the world, the Mona Lisa, many people have noted that if you look closely at her upper lip, you can actually see some of the ligaments and tendons faintly sketched out in her lip. One point of discussion about the Mona Lisa is whether or not she is smiling. And the painting has been scanned with facial recognition software, and she is 88% happy and very sure that she is smiling. So it's quite neat to see how he used visual effects to paint one thing, but to not actually completely portray it if you're not looking for it. One thing that the painting being proven to be smiling has led many people to believe was that the subject was being entertained by clowns and jokers while Da Vinci was painting her. And there's also a theory that Mona Lisa was not actually a woman, but instead Da Vinci's assistant dressed in women's clothes that he was painting. When Da Vinci was in school, he was trained to be a musician, and he was especially trained to play the lyre, and he was trained in art under Andrea del Verrocchio. Later on, when he was about 48 years old, in 1500, he went to Venice to help defend the city against naval attacks. And this is when he really started becoming a military engineer, and we're not exactly sure what things he built to defend the city. Some people think it was like a large dam. But he went on two other times to actually work for defending a city with military inventions. This kind of led him to become known as an inventor, as well as an artist and a theatrical producer. So he did a lot of different things during his time, and he is known for doing all of them extremely well. When he was 65, we have stories from other historians that his right arm became paralyzed, And many people believe this is the reason why many of his paintings, such as Mona Lisa or The Adoration of the Magi, were left unfinished. He has also painted many famous paintings other than Mona Lisa that have become well known in art, and he is definitely remembered as a painter, but he is also remembered as being a very impressive inventor. All right, well, that is the end of our brief summary of Leonardo da Vinci, and now it is time for us to draw a new topic for next week. And for those of you new to the channel, on this channel, what we do is we have a cup of what was 52 topics, and we draw a topic every week and make a video about it. So let's draw our topic for this week. All right, so the new topic is the USS Tang. Wow, so I know very basic information about this, but I do know it is a submarine that was used in World War II. So this is actually the most recent topic that we will have discussed on this channel. So I'm excited to tell you about that. I'll make my video and I'll be back with you guys next week. Bye.